guys, what's up? It's JP here. Welcome back to my channel. Actually, wait, I have some friends to introduce, so we're gonna do that over. These are my friends, Rachel and Leah. So today I am going to be transforming my friends into zombies. So if you guys saw my last video of how I transformed myself into a zombie, yeah, that's what I'm gonna be doing today, except to my friends. If you haven't seen that video, go back and watch it. But if you wanna see how this turns out, then keep watching.
All right, guys, so we're just gonna dive into this. So last time I used my Beauty Blender to blend out the white crew makeup, but it did not work well at all. So today I decided to go for it. My paintbrush, and it actually worked really, really well. I just found out that the paint, I think it's just really cheap. And so I had to do two layers because the first layer just looked really like chipped and like not smooth. But yeah. So after the first coat of the white cream makeup dried, I tried to go in with some white powder that I had to see if it would smooth out, but in the end we just resorted to adding another layer. So now I'm building up that second layer of the white cream makeup, and honestly I'm not sure why I didn't do this in my video. I only did one layer, and like I said, it was like chipped and not smooth, but it worked out okay. But for her, we did the second layer, and it actually worked really well. It smoothed it out. But in the end, she ended up washing off the white cream makeup, and instead we put like her foundation on her face to make her look natural, because the white cream makeup for her made her look like a ghost, more so than a zombie. So now I'm going in with my NYX Ultimate Palette, and I'm taking the red, purple, and blue shades to make her come to life, to make her look like a zombie so she's not just white, washed out. Again, I'm pinning some on her temple, and then I'm giving her a black eye. And in the end, we actually had to go in and add some brown to a lot of areas of her face, just because the blue and the purple and red kind of looked more, cartoon-like or comic-like. Then realistic and natural, which is what we were trying to go for, which is ultimately why we opted for her foundation other than the white cream makeup that she has on now. And after I started to add some different areas of shading, I'm going in with the latex now. And initially I started to make a gash, but the toilet paper did not cooperate with me. So it kind of turned into what I would call some kind of big, gnarly, blistered lump of her face. And actually turned out really cool. It's like textured, and you'll see me build it up soon. But that's how it turned out. And then we did add a gash on her forehead because I did want like a gash, but I kept the blistered area because I thought it looked really, really cool, even though that wasn't what I was going for. So now I am starting on that gash on her forehead. So now that I have my gash setting and the blistered area is dry, I'm going to start some shading. So I'm going in with some red and orange eyeshadow, kind of mixing the two to create like a blistered, bubbling look on her face. Like her face kind of got burnt off and it's still smoldering. So I'm just going in with the fake blood and the Bill Nye Fresca blood to her blister, making it pop. And I'm cutting open her gash and I'm gonna add a mixture of red and a little bit of orange, but mostly red eyeshadow in there. And I'm just adding it to the outskirts of her wound. And I'm going in with the fresh blood to make it pop. And also the Bill Nye Fresca blood to make it all come together. And I'm adding some more toilet paper and latex to her blistered area because it needed more texture. After I added the blood and everything, it just was not enough. So I'm doing that, and then she went to get her BB cream because we hated the look of her white cream makeup. So we tried to put it over the white cream makeup, but it didn't work. So ultimately, she had to wash it off, and we had to add foundation and concealer instead.
Okay, so now that we have gotten it to match her skin tone, I just went in and added some more blood and added some more. I did some more blending, and I'm adding the final touches right now. Just take a walk in my shoes. Come the morning, I'll need you. But tonight I don't wanna fight. Sunday morning when I'm sleeping, find you next to me, I feel it. Sunday morning when I'm sleeping, I feel the mountain need to change. Come the morning, I'll need you. So Rachel's about to come out. Y'all give her a big round of applause. Oh my god. Did y'all see that? The light just flickered.
So, oh my gosh. It looks so cool. It's coming up a little bit, but we fixed it a little bit.
But yeah, please give this video a thumbs up. Because this looks so cool. Like, why wouldn't you not want to give this video a thumbs up? I'm gonna link her YouTube channel down below, actually. We just decided. She decided she didn't want to do it.
It would break out my face.
Yeah.
Leah's face is really sensitive.
Yeah, it's very sensitive, and she didn't want her face to break out. I don't want her face to break out.
Feel like it after all the stuff that just went down.
Comment down below suggestions of what looks I should do on myself or even like my friends next. I really want to know what you guys want me to do. I have some cool ideas planned. But if y'all have any like specific recommendations, just let me know down in the comments. Please go press the subscribe button to my channel. And again, I will link Rachel's YouTube channel down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bro, I never thought we were gonna finish that video.
Yeah. Well, tonight was, is this recording?
Yeah.
Well, tonight was very stressful. I think my heart rate went up here and then it went back down. And then it came all the way up with the roller coaster like this. What's
going on? Yeah. So crazy.
Y'all stress me out.
I will see you guys later. Peace out.
Bye.